Yo, it's Mel from Rap Rankings. To hear the full episode this clip comes from and all other Patreon-exclusive content, visit patreon.com/raprankings.
Track 13, King's Blues, featuring Erykah Badu. Well, it samples her, right?
Yeah, it samples her. She ain't on here. This is Times of Wasting by Erykah Badu.
Right. Well, you know what? Clear! Defibrillator is back. 7+.
8-. Stingy Baby. We follow up my favorite song on the tape, Lions and Lambs, immediately with my second favorite song on the tape, King's Blues.
Listen, it's the best song for me so far on the tape. They hit me with it. They heard I was fading again. They like raised the electric, whatever the unit of measurement is. They put it to my chest and I woke up feeling better than ever.
You got hit. You know, they took the wires from Big Crit's sub and they put them right together. And then they hit you with them on your nipples and you just went, and you did the Macaulay Culkin Home Alone thing with your face, you know?
That's right.
And he was back.
Locked in.
He was back, and your hair is looking like Kodak Black, you know? Looking like that Simpsons or the fucking
at least the
Mario
Simpsons
movie
Kodak
from
Black.
the 90s.
Oh, man.
The live action joint, you know?
Yeah, that fucking Doc Brown, you know?
That Koopa style. Koopa Mel.
Koopa style. Koopa style. All right, yeah, this is my favorite song on the tape so far.
Oh, man. This is a good low-key piece of riding music. We get that cool kind of spacey digital FX sound in there. You get sax, you get guitar, we have the Erykah Badu sample, we have scratching. Very much a multi-layered beat. I'm a big fan of this piece of production on here. One of the best on the whole tape. And I feel like we get good kind of loose flows by K.R.I.T, relatable bars about being broke as fuck, stretching your ends with some McDonald's.
Oh.
I mean, who else out there can relate to, you know, you got to stretch it at the McDonald's. You got to hit that menu, you know?
I mean, this is back. When did the tape drop? Was it 2011? This is back when I think they still had the dollar menu.
The dollar menu was still around. Not to mention, you know, we've been dogging him on some of these choruses throughout this tape. I feel like this is a K.R.I.T chorus that I feel and enjoy.
Mm-hmm.
Not to mention, the Badu shit in there, too, doesn't hurt.
This is the first song on the tape where I feel like he made good on the promise that was circulated on the blogs. Like, this is what I expected to hear when I would hear about, oh, Big K.R.I.T's good, Big K.R.I.T. Like, he's, you know, the new Southern rapper. Mm-hmm. This is what I heard in my mind before ever hearing it.
Perfect verse alert for verse two, especially the end line, my mama tell me be careful because she know when I'm scheming, lottery winners don't run in my family, nor do seven dots when dice starts, so she ain't no sense in me.
Gambling. We just crap out. You know, listen, maybe they listen to me if I pull the strap out, like give me everything, I'm a blackout.
Blackout, because the very strong closer for K.R.I.T on that second verse, I think it's a perfect verse.
Wow.
And, yeah, I mean, this is almost up there with the previous song for me. It's just, I like the music on the last one just a little bit more.
But this one is like, this is the first song where I feel like lyrically I'm hearing things that like justify his, you know, blog era stature. You know, like as
this
an artist
the last
to look
song
out for
me, the rapping from him has just elevated.
You know, like you say a second verse, which is great. I mean, that first verse, when you're talking that McDonald's talk.
Okay. Oh, the McDonald's talk is classic. All right. Look, McDouble fry, lemonade and sweet tea blended.
Blended. Okay. No, I can tell the whole thing because I got to tell you, like, I mean, they know about me. I'm broke as fuck. But as a broke man, sleepy eye forever grind, no bed rest. I can't depend on that next check because it ain't about shit. The type of broke that got me searching through my mama's couch for some loose change, got that dollar menu, McDouble, a small fry, lemonade, and sweet tea blended. Now here it is, Monday, what'll get me through to Wednesday? kill them hunger pains, even though it ain't fulfilling. I make do with what God give me and take it day by day. I would come by more often, but I can't stay. That's my message to all my friends and my family that know. He's like, what do you do? I tell them I'm recording rap at all because I can't do nothing else. I got to get the fuck up out of here. Okay.
Patreon.com/rap soul. Okay.
Yeah.
Patreon.com/rap rankings. $4.99 a month. Get this and much more, folks. YouTube, are you hearing me?
We on YouTube. Is this YouTube?
It's gotta be YouTube.
Please, I'm knocking on the screen.
YouTube.
You hear me knocking?
We don't do the super chat gimmick yet, so if you want to super chat Mools and Mel, join that Patreon, get this whole review, get many, many more reviews, bonus reviews, where that came from. Take care of your boys. Let us get that McDouble. Let us get that small fries. Let us blend the sweet tea and the lemonade. I'll do the unsweetened tea. Because, you know, I ain't on that sookie now time, you know. I'm good with just, you know, a lemon wedge. But please, help out Mools and Mel. And remember, we're big K.R.I.T. fans, okay?
You don't got to lie to the people. This is, look, I'm going to keep it funky with y'all, okay? All right, we're coming up on 1,000 hours. Think about that in music terms, people. Most albums are less than an hour.
Oh, we ain't recorded yet.
By the end of the season, we're gonna be 1,000. Okay, we ended last season. What was it? Season at the end of season 10. I'll tell you right now, we had totaled 923 hours.
Oh, we've probably surpassed that by now. No.
Yeah, we probably have already, folks. Think about that in music terms. That would be like 1,000 albums. And
maybe
I still
more.
Can't afford to move out my grandparents.
Maybe 1,500 albums.
Okay. Like, bro, I don't deserve a studio apartment. I'm just asking for a square fucking room, people. I'm pussy. Okay. All right. Come on.
Time never waits for no man, you know?
Oh, fuck time. Fuck the hourglass. I'm going to hit the drop.
I'm sick of worrying about the government. I can't eat. I'm broke, nigga. I'm broke. And you got the power to change that.
YouTube listener?
Nobody else. You.
You.
God, obviously not our patrons who are listening along right now. You guys are
good. No, they already know what the deal is. They feed Mel McDoubles and small fries and sweet tea and lemonade blended. But y'all ain't doing it, okay? I need your help. I'm not trying to be rich. I just literally want a fucking space of my own.
Hit the Daniel drop. Hit the fucking drop.
Oh, listen, I'm hitting it. I'm hitting it.
I have $1.86.
Please help me. Look, okay. I'm 29, right, y'all? I'll be 30 in April.
Wait, hit the Drake drop.
I gotta do it. I gotta hit him with the whole we on YouTube. I gotta beg and plead, all right?
29.
Years I've been on this fucking earth, and I'm coming up on 30. I think by 30, every man should have a space of his own, a space where he can sleep uninterrupted, where he can masturbate if need be. Okay, what are we doing right now? What are y'all doing to me? I don't want to have no breakdown. That damn Panera Bread, 390 milligrams, is doing the number on me right now. The poverty and the caffeine is whooping my ass, and y'all can save me, okay?
Hit real
this
American.
This is the King's Blues, okay? I'm feeling them.
Hit real American.
The song?
Yeah.
Hopefully Susan doesn't block it.
She ain't blocking
She's a real American, right? She wouldn't block it. Okay, let me... Where that shit? Rick Derringer, right?
Yeah.
My boy Rick, okay. Nigga, where you at?
Maybe Jim Johnston. You might
it's,
want to
it's Jim.
I mean, it just might be, you know, we know it's Rick, but it might be Jim.
Type Rick, the Great Avenger of Slavery. I mean, great album. We reviewed it. Review out now, but no, not that Rick. That's not what I'm looking for. Rick. Oh, damn, Rick and Morty. Where is... See, folks, if I wasn't poor, I'd have one of them Rodecast stoves, and it would be loaded at all times. I would have it on hand, you know?
Oh, Shanky's back, by the way.
Dilser, he's back?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. He eliminated Jinder in a battle royal before getting gunshot eliminated. Gunshot for Dilser. Wow, wonder why he was kept off TV so long by Triple Racist until Daddy came back home.
Is he still dancing?
Yeah, of course.
That's the spirit. That's the spirit. Okay.
You found it?
Windows Explorer says it's working on it. It's searching.
That ain't, oh, all right. Forget it.
Pay folks. Here it is. It finally popped up. Folks, pay me so I can put some old RAM. They said, no, you got 16. Yeah, but I got a lot of porn. And it's clogging the arteries of the RAM. Here we go.
Listen, when you think of America, no, this is good. When you think of America, don't think about this guy. Think about Rav. You think about Rav. You think about Mools and Mel. You think about patreon.com/raprankings. You think about Big Crit. You think about great Americans like Mools, Mel, and Big Crit. You don't think about that Hulk Hogan, okay? So I'm hereby saying, when you want to show your patriotism for America, you have to give Mools and Mel money. You have to give Mools and Mel money. You have to give Mools and Mel money. Patreon.com/raprankings. And this is real. This is what real America is about. Cornbread, slabs, rotating tires, and many fries.
All right. I've had my meltdown. We've been patriotic. We praised Big Crit.
You got anything else to say about the song itself?
It's my favorite song on the tape so far. It took 13 tracks, but we made it. We in the promised land. But spoiler, for those of you listening on YouTube, just sign up to Patreon and hear the rest of the review, because it gets better from here. Okay?
What do you mean?
It gets higher. You know, the ratings go higher.
Oh.
You know? So this ain't even my favorite song on the tape.
Oh, well, it's so all far. Downhill for me from here, because we just heard my two favorite songs.
Okay. All right. Let's move on, okay?
But what could happen? I mean, you'll have to sign up to find out.
That's right. So
you got the pitch, $4.99 a month.
All right. We're also, I guess, we're on SoundCloud, too. We also put the excerpts there, but no one's
there. Hey, SoundCloud. Hey, and also, hey, free feed of the Rab podcast feed.
Oh, yeah, right. No, we're talking to everybody right now. Yeah.
Everyone's going to hear your cries. For salvation. I watched Blade 2 last night. Rewatched.
Oh, did you? How was that?
Not great, you know? I mean, we could talk about it another date, but...
Well, give me a rating. Give me a rating.
A 6. Now, Blade, the original, is like an 8 or a 9 for me. But we have major issues with the script of Blade 2. Some very stupid dialogue in this movie. Some bad CGI. I mean, it was 2002. What else?
I heard the villain in Blade 2 is just Charles Hamilton.
Oh, jeez.
He just goes, vampire.
Look, this villain, there's some cool shit to, like, the angle that they took with the villains, and they're, like, even more dangerous than vampires. You know? There's some cool shit in there where, you know, you got Guillermo del Toro directing, he's gonna put some of his own stamp on it, but this is not I remembered it as a 7, and then at like part one is like an 8 or a 9, but no, this is a 6. This is not good. There's things to like about it, but it doesn't come together. I'm gonna rewatch 3 with Ryan Reynolds and Jessica Biel and Triple H, I believe.
Oh yeah, that was a thing, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Well.
Anyway. Blade 1 is an unfadable classic, though.
I agree.
One of the greatest. You know when it's classic because
you remember where you were. I watched it in my uncle's room. I remember. It must have been, when did Blade come out?
98.
All right. Well, it was on VHS, so
maybe 99.
Yeah, I might have saw it in 99, maybe 98, but anyway. All right.
I didn't see it in theaters. I rented it on I'm pretty sure DVD, so probably like 99, 2000 for me.
Ah, okay. Blade's coming back, y'all.
I mean, we got the classic bloody rave scene. Oh, RIP Jesse.
Jesse, if Jesse died due to boredom because we're talking about Blade, I'm going to hit him with this, first of all, because that's a...
And you ain't black.
Blade is a black folk classic. Don't even ask me how. It just is. And he ain't vampire. And he ain't Wesley Snipes either.
We don't know.
No, we know that Jesse ain't zombies. Zombies.
Oh, wait. Jesse doesn't listen to Patreon reviews.
Yeah, but he listens to the feed, you know? Right?
I don't think he listens to the song snippets.
He ain't Rab either. I'm saying it. Okay? You ain't Rab.
By the way, Jesse
has sat in with us for like 7 hours.
Did you get his January check to continue to allow him to call himself the third member or what? Because I didn't see anything in the account.
I saw no record of this.
Interesting. Well, I don't think he can keep calling himself that. He's not going to continue to pay us. Wait, is this on the air still?
do you want to move on?
Yeah, just edit that part out where I say about the checks.
Okay.
Yo, it's Mel from Rap Rankings. To hear the full episode this clip comes from and all other Patreon exclusive content, visit patreon.com/raprankings.